ECG or electrocardiogram is a common test used to monitor the electrical activity of the heart. They can help you to diagnose a range of heart diseases, including arrhythmias, heart attack, and heart failure. The heart has its own electrical system that controls the heartbeat. The electrical impulses originate in the sinoatrial node or SA node and then travel through the heart chambers, causing them to contract and pump blood. An ECG measures the electrical activity of the heart and produces a graph that shows the rhythm and timing of each heartbeat. The graph is made up of waves and segments that represent different phases of the heart's electrical cycle. The P wave represents the electrical activity that occurs when the atria contract. The QRS complex represents the electrical activity that occurs when the ventricle contract. And the T wave represents the repolarization of the ventricles. Now, to perform an ECG, electrodes are placed on the skin of the chest, arms and legs, and we have to make sure they're placed at the correct positions. V1 is placed at the fourth intercostal space at the right sternal border. V2 is placed at the fourth intercostal space at the left sternal border. Now, you don't place V3, rather you place V4, which is at the fifth intercostal space in the midclavicular line. And then you place V3 in between V2 and V4. V5 is placed at the 5th intercostal space at the anterior axial line. V6 is placed at the 5th intercostal space in the mid-axial line. Next, apply the electrodes to the patient's arms and legs. Again, make sure they're placed in the correct positions. Red, marked with the letter R, is for the right arm. Yellow, marked with the letter L, is for the left arm. Green, marked with the letter F, is for the left leg. Black, marked with the letter N, for neutral, is for the right leg. Once all the electrodes are in place, turn on the ECG machine and follow the instructions to start the test. These electrodes pick up the electrical signals from the heart and transmit them to the ECG machine, which produces the graph. Here's an example of the ECG graph with annotations. As you can see, the P wave precedes the QRS complex, which is followed by the T wave. The PR interval represents the time it takes for the electrical impulse to travel from the SA node to the ventricle. The QT interval represents the time it takes for the ventricles to contract and then relax. That's the basics of ECG. I hope this video has helped you in understanding a little bit about the ECG. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.